When we talk about companies becoming more agile, ultimately what we're meaning is that they need to have the ability to respond quickly to unexpected and changing circumstances. By definition, that means that they are responding to events, to stimuli that have never happened before. Otherwise, they would be predictable, they would be routinized. Now, when we are responding to situations that have not happened before, or that in some cases can't or have not been predicted, we are going to be doing things we haven't done before. And the trick with this for companies is that so often in our routine work, we expect perfection. And we have to have perfection. Certainly for many types of work, you have to have the systems in place that guarantee a certain outcome. But we need to have a different mindset when it comes to agility, because the truth is, failure is going to happen when you are faced with things that you have never done before. Definitionally, that is the case. Now, oftentimes there is a too glib discourse around celebrating failure, embracing failure, leaning into failure. No one likes it. No one likes to fail. It's not easy. But what we need to have, I believe, instead, is an understanding that in agile circumstances, perfection can't be the goal. It shouldn't be the goal, because we can never achieve that when we're fundamentally doing something new. They're contradictory. If we're going to be perfect, that means that it has been perfected through multiple times, multiple iterations, and in order to get to that standard, you have to experiment. And so we need to have a culture of safety, of psychological safety, as my colleague Amy Edmondson talks about, so that people understand that your head is not going to be on the chopping block if you try something new and it doesn't work at first. Agility is about learning. Many executives have come up under different business circumstances where there's predictability, there's stability. And the truth is, as humans, many of us still cling to that reality. But I think that the worst thing that we can do is to shake our fist at the sky and say, well, why isn't it still that way? Why can't we continue banking on what has always worked? Frankly, that is a form of arrogance. It's a form of entitlement, because what our job is not simply to replicate the behaviors that have always worked. That's a part of it. We need to do that. We need to continue maximizing the successes that we have. But we also, to be effective, need to learn to scan the horizon for new trends, new threats, and understand where we can be making our mark. For all of us, we need to be allocating a portion of our cognitive resources and our financial and mental resources to know what is coming around the corners and understand that that is actually what our jobs are. When we think about reinvention and the need for professional reinvention, we need to constantly be pushing ourselves, because when it comes to 21st century skills, agility and the ability to reinvent is foundational, because the job that we have today, even if the title stays the same, it's not going to be the same job in 2 years, because the requirements and the circumstances will have changed. And every executive needs to understand and appreciate that. For executives to be truly agile, there are a few behaviors that they can implement on a regular basis. One is to really think deeply about the nature of their networks, because there are a lot of things, there are a lot of problems that we can Google the answers to, but when it comes to top executives, top leaders, the problems and the solutions that are entailed are bespoke. This is not something that you can get from a book or a manual or from what you find online. You need to have tightly crafted, unique responses. And the way that you can gather knowledge like that, situational knowledge that you don't currently possess, is through a wide network of people that you can tap in particular circumstances. Now, the problem for most executives, as I have seen, is that fundamentally we tend to over-index on what is known as bonding capital, relationships with people who are fundamentally like ourselves. They work in the same industry, they work in the same company. Demographically, they're like us. What we need to do periodically is have a network audit so that we understand who we're connected to now and where our deficits are, so that we can make sure that we are making an equal push, sometimes an even greater push, into bridging capital, building relationships with people who are dissimilar to us, so that we can have genuine warm friendships with people before we need them, so that we can learn from them and learn to understand what is coming on the horizon so that we can be ready for it. And if a situation emerges, we will know exactly who to go to, who has expertise and insights that we don't. I think that that is the first goal that executives can take charge of right now to make themselves more agile. The second piece that I will mention is the importance of understanding that in the contemporary economy, there is a push, frankly, for better or for worse, in all sectors toward rising inequality. And by inequality, I mean that fundamentally, the people who already have recognition, the people who are already getting accolades, in some ways are going to continue to get more of that. As things get noisier, then we rely on people who already are known as experts, as a trusted voice. And so one of the most valuable things that any leader can do is to really make the investment in becoming a thought leader inside their company and beyond, because that expertise becomes recognized and they are then able to transfer it to other realms. That credibility comes with them and it makes them more effective in everything that they do.